Hola, it's Joshua. I'd like to welcome you to our 5-part course of the court process. Now I know what you're thinking, what is even the meaning of the court process? But that's why we're here. We're here to help and explain all kinds of questions that you may have, like how tall is Patrick Swayze? We may never know, but what we do know is, procedural due process is a citizen's right for access to the courts and a fair treatment. While substantive due process protects basic freedoms in court, while enumerated rights are privileges not listed in the Constitution.
Shalom. Hello, my name is Austin. You can tell I'm Austin because of my monotone voice. Anyways, due process is the fair treatment through the normal judicial process. Substantive due process is the principle allowing courts to protect certain fundamental rights from government interference. The right to privacy is one's personal info is protected from public scrutiny.
Oh, hello there. I'm illegal. The government gives us a considerable amount of privacy at home. Freedom of Info Act Day encourages the government to release info to the public, while privacy at school is very little, and the school gives you very little privacy. And thanks to the Privacy Act, Ocho 74A, it prevents the government from releasing info without written consent.
In the court system, due process contemplates an exercise of the powers of government as the new law permits and sanctions, under recognized safeguards for the protection of individual rights. I would know. I'm Jewish. Remember Watergate?
You mean the gate of the water?
What?
Shut up.
You suck.
You suck. You can't even go 5 seconds without cursing. I'm gonna have to bleep that out, and no one's even gonna understand.
No, just take it out. Take it out. Take it out.
We'll have a word from our sponsors. Hola, it is I, Pablo Diego Jose Francisco de Paula Juan Nepenitico Maria de los Remedios Capriana de la Santissima Trinidad Ruiz y Pacasio de Montevala III. And today we are in my hometown, Puerto Rico, with a crime rate that's non-existent and I just completely made up of about 90%. It has been very rough here, especially with the lions. Now let me tell you about a court case that relates to the due process procedure. In the Texas versus Johnson case, Gregory Lee Johnson burned an American flag outside the convention center where the 1984 Republican National Convention was being held in Dallas, Texas. Johnson burned the flag to protest the policies of President Ronald Reagan. He was arrested and charged with violating a Texas statute that prevented the discrimination of a venerated object, including the American flag, if such an action were likely to incite anger in others. A Texas court tried and convicted Johnson. He appealed, arguing that his actions were symbolic speech, protected by the First Amendment. The Supreme Court agreed to hear his case. The issue was whether flag burning constitutes symbolic speech protected by the First Amendment. The ruling was yes. It was 5-4. The majority of the court, according to Justice William Brennan, agreed with Johnson and held that flag burning constitutes a form of symbolic speech that is protected by the First Amendment. The majority noted that freedom of speech protects actions that society may find very offensive, but society's outrage alone is not justification for suppressing free speech. It is because of Amendment 10 that this was able to happen. Amendment 10 are the non-enumerated rights, the rights that are not listed in the Constitution. Those rights consist of right to an abortion based on right to privacy, right to choose and follow a profession, right to attend and report a criminal trials, right to receive equal protection not only from the states but also from the federal government, right to a presumption of innocence and demand proof beyond reasonable doubt before being convicted of a crime, right to assist you with others, right to privacy, right to travel within the United States, right to marry not to marry, right to make loans recent but not having children.
Abortion is the single most controversial issue involving reproduction in the United States. The issue turns on whether a woman should have the right to terminate a pregnancy, that would amount to a living human being if remained untouched. On the one hand, pro-choice advocates argue that abortion falls within a person's constitutional right to privacy, believing the choice to terminate an unborn fetus lies with the individual and her doctor. On the other hand, pro-life advocates argue that a fetus is a living being at the moment of conception and argues abortion should be criminalized to protect the life of the unborn fetus.
That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June. I said that's life.
That's life.
And as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream. But I don't let it get me down. 'Cause this fine old world, it keeps spinning around. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life.
That's life.
I tell you, I can't deny it. I thought of quitting, baby, but my heart just ain't gonna buy it. And if I didn't think it was worth one single try, I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball and